Good morning, Tigers, and welcome back to the world's greatest elementary school. This is another big week at Shadow Lake. It is also our last full week before spring break. All of our fifth graders will be going to Camp Casey on Wednesday morning, and we'll be at camp until Friday afternoon. Fifth graders, remember you need to be dropped off at school at 7:30 a.m. on Wednesday, April 3rd. With all of your gear and luggage, you'll be returning between 2 and 2:30 on Friday, April 5th. On Friday after dismissal, this is when our spring break starts. There won't be school next week. April 9th through 12th, classes will resume on Monday, April 15th.
Last week, we got to recognize our March Students of the Month for showing the trait of being strategic problem solvers. We'll show their pictures in just another moment. Now that we are into April, we have a whole new trait we're gonna be working on, and this month's trait is being a creative innovator. These are students who think up new ideas and then put them into practice. We are so excited to see all of our Tigers grow in this area over the month of April. But now, as promised, here are our March Students of the Month for being strategic problem solvers.
Last Thursday, our third graders, under the direction of Mrs. Moore, presented an amazing concert. I loved it. Congratulations to all of our third graders for such a great performance. Special thanks to all of our third grade teachers, and a huge thank you to Mrs. Moore. Here are some pictures from last week's concert.
Alright Tigers, it is time to order this year's yearbook. The online ordering link is available this week. Orders placed online by April 14th will only be charged $20. Now beginning on April 15th, online orders will cost $25. Order forms with check or money can be returned to the office for $20 until April 30th, and then beginning on May 1st, there'll be time to order yearbooks for last chance for $25. So get in those orders as soon as possible and save money.
Yep. All right, Tigers, remember it is time to get your March Pause reading logs turned in. Now that we are into April, we want to encourage every one of our Tigers, whether if you've done Pause reading this year or not, to take part in Pause reading the rest of the school year. For any reading you do outside of school, whether you read, you do the reading, you read to a caregiver, a sibling, or if somebody reads to you, log that time, even a pet. Turn in that Pause reading log. We have some special prizes for the months of March, April, and May. We are going to be doing some additional special prizes and drawings. So spend time reading at home and get in those Pause logs. Okay, Mr. Abbey, what's on this week's lunch menu?
All right, Tigers, here is this week's lunch menu. Today is ciabatta cheese melt. That's a new item. Mm-hmm. Tuesday is gonna be chicken nuggets. Wednesday is brunch for lunch. Thursdays, we're having nachos with turkey meat. And then Friday, how about pizza? And this week, we'll have all of those special recess programs. We'll have Lunch Bunch during lunchtime on Wednesday in the Tiger Den. And we have Recess Club on Tuesday and Thursday during your lunch recess. And you can also get out there and earn more mileage this week during Workout Wednesday. And then fourth graders, don't forget, there is going to be a green team meeting during your lunch recess Thursday in Mrs. Bradley's room. And our Tiger TV video production has two segments for you today, a Guess the Segment, and then we have another, a Guess the Object segment and another Joke of the Week. Check them out.
Tigers, we have some really sad news. We regret to inform you
that Tiger TV has been canceled
due to expenses
and global warming
and stink bug infestations
and people breaking in and eating our equipment.
So we can never do this again. But Tigers, we have something to tell you.
April Fools!
Tigers, we are back with a segment called Guess the Object. We will zoom in on an object and you will try to guess what it is.
Can you guess what it is?
How about now?
Can you guess it now?
Now?
It's the Bing Toy!
Hello, Tigers. We are back with the Joke of the Week. Are you ready? What do you call a fake noodle? An impasta.
All right, Tigers, it's time to recognize more of our amazing Tigers who have been earning those Tiger Paw tickets, and we're selected in this week's drawing. For kindergarten, we have Poppy in Mrs. Stamp's class, Emerson in Mrs. Hurley's class, Scarlett in Miss Belmondo's class, and Finn in Mrs. K's class.
Way to go, kindergartners. Moving on to first grade. Indio, you were selected in Miss DeGroote's room. Monroe, you are the winner in Mrs. Papini's class. Bash, congratulations, you were selected in Mrs. Yassine's. Haley, you're the winner in Mrs. Unruh's class. And then Bowen, congratulations, you were selected in Mrs. Nelson's room.
Nice job, first graders. Moving on to second grade, we have Kaysen in Mrs. Kortenkamp's class, Anastasia in Ms. LaClesha's class, Evan in Mrs. Shireman's room, and Hudson in Mrs. Meek's class.
All right, moving on to our third grade winners. Congratulations to Danny, you were selected in Mrs. Boyle's room. Julian, you're the winner in Mr. McMaster's class. Jackson, you were selected in Mrs. McAllen's room. And then Jude, you are the winner in Mr. Schlag's class.
All right, moving on to fourth grade, we have winners Wesley F. in Mrs. Bradley's class, Bronson in Mrs. Moffitt's room, and Theron in Mrs. Isley's class.
All right, for all of our fifth grade campers, here are our winners. Adeline, you are the winner in Mr. K's room. Noah, you're the winner in Mrs. Lish's class. And then congratulations to Jacob, who was selected in Mrs. Heater's class.
Winners, when it is convenient for your class, they'll send you to the office to pick up your prize from the Tiger Paw treasure chest. All right, Mr. Abbey, what's going on with story time this week?
All right, Mrs. Smith, our Shadow Lake librarian, is back reading a story called If You Happen to Have a Dinosaur. Hope that you enjoy it.
All right, Tigers, we hope you all have a great week and a fun and relaxing spring break. And remember,
it's a great day to be a tiger.
Hey, Tigers, welcome back to Storytime. I'm Mrs. Smith. I'm super excited to read another awesome story. So some of you may have noticed that I have not been in the library lately. So Miss Shauna has sort of taken over my spot and I am in the office now, kind of full time, just to help out for a while. We're just a little short staffed. So anyways, Miss Shauna has stepped up into my role and I will be in the office. So I totally miss you guys. I hope you guys come in and say hi to me, show me what books you're checking out, all of those things. So just remember that, make sure you show the Tiger Way for Miss Shauna. And I can't wait to see you guys in the library again, but come say hi to me in the office. But I will still be reading for story time, so I'm super excited for that. So today I picked out this fun one, If You Happen to Have a Dinosaur. This is written by Linda Bailey. This was an award-winning story quite a few years ago, 2015. It's hard to believe that's almost 10 years ago. All right. Ooh, and this is kind of a big story, so let's see. See if we can get it in the screen. It says, if you happen to have a dinosaur lying around your living room and you don't know what to do with it. Maybe you could use it as a can opener. It would make a great coffee grinder too, or a nutcracker, or a potato masher. And if you need a burglar alarm, your dinosaur's just the thing. There are oodles of things you can do with a dinosaur. Try taking it into your yard. It will mow your lawn, trim your trees, blow your leaves, and dig you a garden in no time flat. Yes, a dinosaur is handy any season of the year. On rainy days, it makes a fine umbrella. In winter, it's a snowplow. And on hot summer days, just park it by the pool. Your friends will line up to try your exciting new diving board. Just think of all the things your dinosaur can do. Does it have sharp teeth? You can use it to shred paper. It will also be a great excuse if you forgot your homework. Some dinosaurs make wonderful babysitters, but not all dinosaurs are suited to this work. Some dinosaurs make excellent kites, but not all dinosaurs are suited to this work either. I don't think he's going anywhere. There are some things a dinosaur is just not good for at all. Do not ask your dinosaur to carry your picnic basket. Nope, that does not look like a good idea. Or push your grocery cart, or hold your popcorn bowl. If you study your dinosaur carefully, you'll be able to use it wisely. A small dinosaur will make a dandy pillow, or a footstool, or a bookmark. Look at the little dinosaur bookmark. We'll see if we can pass some of those out in the library. A tall dinosaur will clean your roof drains, wash your windows, and rescue your kitty. Lickety split. Once you start using your dinosaur, you'll never want to stop. The possibilities are amazing. And if you treat your dinosaur well, you will have it for a very, very long time. And what if you don't happen to have a dinosaur lying around your living room? Not everyone does. What if you have an octopus instead? Or a porcupine, a penguin, a saber tooth, a Sasquatch, a dodo, or a camel, or a kangaroo? What can you do with a kangaroo? Oh boy, I think I might know what the next story is. All right, Tigers, I hope you enjoyed that one. If you happen to have a dinosaur, oh man, there's so many things we could do with the dinosaur around here. All right, Tigers, just a reminder, remember, show the Tiger Way in the library. We got lots of fun stuff coming up this month. You're going to vote for your favorite picture book. We'll do that at the end of the month. You've got Miss Shauna in there, so you guys have lots of fun stuff ahead of you. All right, remember, it's a great day to be a tiger.